Good morning. Welcome to Morning Prayer.
Abba, Father, let me be yours and yours alone. May my will forever be evermore your own. Abba, Father, let me be yours and yours alone. May my will forever.
Since we have a great high priest who has passed into the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God, let us with confidence draw near to the throne of grace. Blessed be the Lord our God, by whose grace we are led alive. Blessed be his Son, Jesus Christ, by whose rising we are set free. Blessed be the Spirit of God, in whom is all hope and all joy. Let us pray. Father, come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship bear witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed for us. So let us celebrate the feast, not with the old leaven of corruption and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Christ, once raised from the dead, dies no more. Death has no more dominion over him. In dying, he died to sin once for all. In living, he lives to God. See yourselves, therefore, as dead to sin and alive to God in Jesus Christ our Lord. Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who sleep. For as by man came death, by man has come also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, even so in Christ shall all be made alive. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Set us free, O God, from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life which you have made known to us in your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Psalms appointed for today are Psalms 107 and 108.
Psalm 107. The Lord changed rivers into deserts, and water springs into thirsty ground.
A fruitful land into salt flats, because of the wickedness of those who dwelt there.
He changed deserts into pools of water, and dry land into water springs.
He settled the hungry there, and they founded a city to dwell in.
They sowed fields and planted vineyards, and brought in a fruitful harvest.
He blessed them, so that they increased greatly. He did not let their herds decrease.
Yet when they were diminished and brought low, through stress of adversity and sorrow,
he pours contempt on princes and makes them wander in trackless wastes.
He lifted up the poor out of misery and multiplied their families like flocks of sheep.
The upright will see this and rejoice, but all wickedness will shut its mouth.
Whoever is wise will ponder these things and consider well the mercies of the Lord.
Psalm 108. My heart is firmly fixed, O God, my heart is fixed. I will sing and make melody.
Wake up, my spirit, awake, lute and harp. I myself will waken at the dawn.
I will confess you among the peoples, O Lord. I will sing praises to you among the nations.
For your loving kindness is greater than the heavens, and your faithfulness reaches to the clouds.
Exalt yourself above the heavens, O God, and your glory over all the earth,
so that those who are dear to you may be delivered. Save with your right hand and answer me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
A reading from the Word of the Lord, written in Paul's letter to the Ephesians, Chapter 6, verses 10 to 24. Finally, be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his power. Put on the whole armor of God, so that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For our struggle is not against enemies of blood and flesh, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic powers of this present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, so that you may be able to withstand on that evil day, and having done everything, to stand firm. Stand therefore, and fasten the belt of truth around your waist, and put on the breastplate of righteousness. As shoes for your feet, put on whatever will make you ready to proclaim the gospel of peace. With all of these, take the shield of faith, with which you will be able to quench all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. Pray in the Spirit at all times, in every prayer and supplication. To that end, keep alert and always persevere in supplication for all the saints. Pray also for me, so that when I speak, a message may be given to me to make known with boldness the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in chains. Pray that I may declare it boldly, as I must speak. So that you also may know how I am and what I am doing, Tychicus will tell you everything. He is a dear brother and a faithful minister in the Lord. I am sending him to you for this very purpose, to let you know how we are and to encourage your hearts. Peace be to the whole community, and love with faith from God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Grace be with all who have an undying love for our Lord Jesus Christ. The Word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Song of the Redeemed. O ruler of the universe, Lord God, great deeds are they that you have done, surpassing human understanding. Your ways are ways of righteousness and truth. O King of all ages, who can fail to do you homage, Lord, and sing the praises of your name? For you only are the Holy One. All nations will draw near and fall down before you, because your just and holy works have been revealed. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
A reading from the Word of God, written in the Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 9, verses 18 to 26. While he was saying these things to them, suddenly a leader of the synagogue came in and knelt before him, saying, "My daughter has just died, but come and lay your hand on her, and she will live." And Jesus got up and followed him with his disciples. Then suddenly, a woman who had been suffering from hemorrhages for 12 years came up behind him and touched the fringe of his cloak. For she said to herself, "If I only touch his cloak, I will be made well." Jesus turned, and seeing her, he said, "Take heart, daughter, your faith has made you well." And instantly, the woman was made well. When Jesus came to the leader's house and saw the flute players and the crowd making a commotion, he said, "Go away, for the girl is not dead but sleeping." And they laughed at him. But when the crowd had been put outside, he went in and took her by the hand, and the girl got up. And the report of this spread throughout that district. The Word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Ever so often, you know, I just can't find any other way to put it but direct. And I just want to say to all of us, stand firm in our faith. We believe in Jesus Christ, hold your faith. Stay right there. Paul writes and he says, put on the armor of God. That's very important, so that we are ready for battle. We are not tossed to and fro by the naysayers and all of the negative things that come at us, but that we hold firm, hold our position, and prepare to battle our way through. And we see that there was a battle with this man. Of course, in this particular gospel, he is not named, but in the other gospels, they refer to him as the, it's possible that it's Jairus, and we know about the healing of Jairus's daughter. So Jairus was somebody that had high standing in society, and he had money. And here he comes on his knees asking Jesus to heal his daughter who is pronounced dead. And this is important for us, because look at this. This man's faith did not just bring his daughter back to life, but somebody else was healed on the way. Because on the way, Jesus responded to him. He said, come and touch my daughter. And Jesus went. And on their way, a crowd interrupts him. A crowd blocks their way. In the middle of the crowd is somebody else with an issue. Jesus is on his way, and then somebody else is coming along that path that helps them, receive healing from him as well. This was another woman. She had another issue. She had an issue for more than 12 years that she was separated from society. She was just shunned because she bled for so long. She didn't have a husband and a whole host of things. And in this scripture, shows us how far he's willing to go, or at least how close he's willing to stay to us. Meaning, she was shunned by society. Didn't matter disability, didn't matter disease, didn't matter. He disregarded all of it, and he still went close, or allowed her to get close, because he recognized what happened and he spoke to her. She touched his garments, she was healed, and he spoke to her saying, your faith has healed you. Now, society question, of course, why is she going so close to him? She's sick. And you know, we start to hail and label and point each other out based on whatever fault issue we might be having. But Jesus was not like that. As a matter of fact, he didn't even call her. Oh, you're the woman who has been in for so many years. Why are you so close to me? No, your faith. So he acknowledges and points out what she has done. And saying this now shows others that you don't have the kind of issue that she has. Yet she still chases after me, Jesus. And her faith made her well outside of that. So here is, she is one proving to us, standing firm, because she's shunned, separated from society, but she makes her way through the crowd. One scripture will tell you, she's crawling on the ground in between everybody just to touch the hem of his garments. And so she does all of that, not considering what others are saying. Somebody probably mash her hand. She probably get a little kick because everybody is rushing to this Jesus with their own issues. But she pushes through. She fights her way through to make it to him. And she receives his best because of it. So she stands firm in her resolve, knowing and trusting that God there, he can heal me. Then coming right back, they continue on their journey. Now remember, this guy comes to Jesus on his knees. That takes a lot. That takes a lot, because this is a high-ranking guy. He has servants, he's a leader, he has money. And here he is on his knees, not to worship as some writers would put it, but to plead his case. Bears it all, humbles himself. Conviction, that takes a lot of courage, that takes a lot of faith, knowing that he, this divine individual, he's the only one that can help my child, my loved one, or save me from. And so he stands firm. Jesus says, let's go. He carries Jesus to his home, and there we see it again. The crowd is saying, give up, let it go, she died. He puts everybody out and he shuts the door. Standing firm. And this is what we need to do sometimes. Just shut everybody else out, and you and God alone in that room. Work it through to success, work it through to resurrection, work it through to life, new life, work it through to God's purpose, work it through to wherever you need to be. Work it through, friends in Christ. We need to grow in our faith with this God so that we can have faith like the woman with the blood issue, like Jairus, or this gentleman, if that is not his name, that God will, because he was ready. He didn't even have a whole discourse. Jairus said, come please. And he went. He's ready to serve, ready to give, ready to release and share, ready to bless, ready to if we would receive him, if we would grow in our faith and believe in him, if we would trust in him, if we would stand firm and not be tossed to and fro by the naysayers, by the crowd, by those who get in our way, but hold firm and trust God for that response. I don't even want to say healing. It's just, it is a response, because it can be anything and everything. So I'm not going to narrow it down to one particular thing, but just this example to show us he is not far from us. He is ready and willing to help us and bring us out of our distress. He loves us. God loves you. Get to know him. Build your faith and trust in him by studying his word, by taking the little bits of being obedient and learning to hear his voice, by gathering people around you that have a similar mind to chase after Christ. Grow your faith. Amen.
Standing on the promises of Christ my King, through eternal ages let his praises ring. Glory in the highest I will shout and sing. Standing on the promises of God, standing, standing, standing on the promises of God my Savior, standing, standing, I'm standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises I cannot fall, listening every moment to the Spirit's call, resting in my Savior as my all in all. Standing on the promises of God, standing, standing, standing on the promises of Christ my Savior, standing, standing, I'm standing on the promises of God.
So let us confess our faith, or in some cases learn our faith, using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Lord, reveal your love among us, that we may know the joy of your salvation. Grant peace within and among all nations, and teach our leaders wisdom. Endow your church with faithfulness, and her servants with knowledge and true godliness. Defend, O Lord, the rights of the poor and the oppressed, that your justice may be known among all people. Lord, renew your spirit within us, that in us and through us your will may be done. O God, the King of glory, you have exalted your only Son, Jesus Christ, with great triumph to your kingdom in heaven. Do not leave us comfortless, but send your Holy Spirit to strengthen us and exalt us to that place where our Savior Christ has gone before, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God in glory everlasting. Amen. Eternal God and Father, by whose power we are created and by whose love we are redeemed, guide and strengthen us by your Spirit, that we may give ourselves to your service and live this day in love for you and one another. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I invite us to offer our own petitions at this time. Let us pray for support. Eternal light, shine into our hearts. Eternal goodness, deliver us from evil. Eternal power, be our support. Eternal wisdom, scatter the darkness of our ignorance. Eternal pity, have mercy upon us, that with all our heart and mind and soul and strength, we may seek your face and be brought by your infinite mercy to your holy presence. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our prayer of dedication. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons. In the power of the Holy Spirit, and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we can ask or conceive, by the power which is at work among us, to him be the glory in the Church and in Christ Jesus throughout all ages. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Do have a wonderful weekend, everyone. God bless you.